Everybody, Dr. Cranky here once again in the laboratory. It is Tuesday and it's gonna be a good day. I can see it already through the window. The sun's coming up. We're up bright and early. We are rested. We are good to go. Dave Parker posted a new video, wonderful video, where he talks about a random act of kindness that he received from Andy. And, you know, none of that stuff surprises me, either from Andy or from, the rest of the folks in this YouTube community. A lot of generous people out there. And so it just, it's a great sign. It's a great sign. And, and it's really a wonderful way of sharing and keeping the hobby going, you know, to know that if somebody needs something, somebody comes to the rescue. A toast, a coffee toast to all the wonderful people out there. All right, so we are continuing with the Lucky Sevens. A lot of you are getting surprised, keep an eye out on your mailbox. I wanted to utilize a little bit of this video to talk about, you know, what I've, you know, time and again keep coming back to and calling my insurance policy. You know, I have an insurance policy, my wife's got that, but then I also, when I'm building models, I like to think that, you know, if anything goes wrong, then I have a backup. And I learned this a long time ago the hard way when I first got back into the hobby. I started building the 1950 Chevy pickup, and I ruined, four or five of those right out of the box. Just because I was learning, or I would get frustrated. Just to give you an idea, I remember dipping a model in nail polish remover. Okay, just to give you an idea, not to be tried at home, kids. But that's the kind of stuff that when you are building models and you're on your own and you're alone doing it with nobody guiding you, it's you hit your head against the wall quite a few times. And so, you know, it's good to know that there are folks out there who are jumping in to help everybody else out so that you don't make mistakes. Now, remember this, we are all human, right? So we're all going to keep making mistakes. I make mistakes. Don Yost makes mistakes. I just heard from Don this week and he was upset because, he said Murphy, that's what he calls it. Murphy was in his house and it was, problematic, but we all do that, and that's how we learn from our mistakes. But having said that, you know, I, as I said, not that I'm always in a hurry to build a model, but you know, once I'm in the zone, I want to keep it going. So the last thing you want is to work on your chassis, to work on your engine, to work on your interior, and it doesn't matter what you do first or last, but oftentimes you will get to the body and you paint it and the darn thing just doesn't turn out right, and there's the engine, the chassis, and the interior waiting. I'll show you. I'm gonna build these suckers coming up. So there they are, same model, you know. One, you know, I prep them both, I get them ready for primer and paint. And of course, you know what model that is, right? This is on Dr. Cranky's top 10, possibly top 3. And I'll always build. I mean, I built so many of these and I'll continue building it. So basically, you know, you go through the extra step and you prep and you primer and you get two vehicles ready. And, you know, if they both turned out nice, then you've got two nice models. If one needs to go into the purple pond, then you've got one left. I've done it so that, you know, sometimes two or three models will have to go into the purple pond, but that's a different story. So you just, you know, I know it's expensive, but once you get to the point where you are doing this out of pure unadulterated addiction, as I would like to call it, that's how I do it. I get two models, three. Sometimes if I see a model that I know I'm going to build several times, like the 41 Willis and the 49 Merc, I usually just troll, you know, Amazon and then eBay looking for good deals. Over the holidays, I was able to find the 41 Willis for something like $14.99, and then the 49 Merc for $15.16, something like that. And you know, and so when that happens, I snap them up, and yeah, it's the same model over and over and over. But you know, it's my approach to the madness, and why not? I really enjoy those kits, and those of you who've built them, you know what I'm talking about. Anyway, that's basically it. I mean, I like to have that insurance policy, because I don't want to have to stop and then run back to the hobby shop, and what if they don't have it anymore? This has happened. Then I have to get online, I have to order it. By the time the new parts arrive, the whole build has gotten cold, and it's no longer as much fun as it is. So that's just my take on it. And again, for those of you who are youngsters on a tight budget, you know, you might not be able to do this, but you know, definitely don't drive yourself crazy. If you make a mistake, you know, put the word out, and maybe somebody will come to the rescue with a part, or bite the bullet and then wait the time that you have to wait while the part dunks in the purple pond or the green pond or whatever pond you've got going on there. I am wearing another gift from a good friend I just received, and you know, it's just, I'm amazed. A lot of amazing generosity. So, on that note, folks, I will run off and get more work done, and stay tuned in for more videos. There will always be more videos through this brand new season of the Cranky Show. So. Until next time, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory, and here's to all of you. Keep up the good work, and keep stay addicted, my friends. All right, bye-bye.